We're with Joe Edwards, gold medalist once again. Joe, it was a heck of a fight, but how are you feeling at this moment? Everything that's happened in the last few hours?
Look, a bit knackered, to be fair. You know, it's been a bit of a roller coaster kind of final, and one that I possibly think I was a little bit lucky to come out on top on, but you know, played really well the last eight ends and just put Laura under a bit of pressure, and lucky enough it worked.
What got you through though? Where's the mental strength come through to fight? And you were well down.
Yeah, look, I was pretty calm. You know, I had a talk to our sports psych, John Quinn, and it's just an amazing guy, and he just puts you at ease all the time. And I was comfortable. I was five down, and where other times I've probably been a little bit panicky. I'm five down. You got to do this. And tonight it was just like, well, you're only five down. And you know, string a couple of ends together and you're back in it. And so it was kind of a wee calmness. It was quite nice.
It sounds fabulous, and it obviously worked out well. You've been here, you've done this before, back to back. Could you have imagined doing that even just a wee while back?
No, you know, you get lucky enough to be picked in the single spot. You know, it's a lonely spot when you're not doing well, but it's a pretty cool spot to be in when you are doing well. And you know, back to back, I'm not really a big one for that. It's, you know, 4 years ago, I was 4 years younger. It was in Glasgow, completely foreign conditions. Here, it's pretty much on my back doorstep from where we live. And so, you know, you just want to be playing at the pointy end of a tournament. And yeah, tonight, played in the final, yeah.
When you see it and you look at that very beautiful shiny medal, what does that represent to you?
It represents a lot of pride, a lot of hard work. A lot of payback to a lot of people that have helped me along the way. You know, I've got such an amazing support group behind me that, you know, that are both here and at home. And it's just like almost a little thank you to everyone.
There's a heck of a support group at home too, I'm sure, as well. I mean, for your sport, this is always the Commonwealth Games come around, it's bowls moment in the sun, and you've nailed it.
Yeah, I suppose, you know. Look, us as bowlers, we, you know, we just want to get out that, you know, we work hard at what we do, and I suppose, you know, getting a little bit of a limelight, it's not just about me, it's about the sport of lawn bowls as a whole, and I just hope it gets out there and people, you know, look at the sport and young people look at the sport as if it's a sport that can take you places now. And you know, I've been amazed with where I've gone and the friends I've met, the people, places I've been, and it's an awesome sport. It's one of the hardest I've played.
Where on earth do you go from here then?
Probably about 12 hours time, pairs at Broadbeach Bowling Club with Val Smith. So.
And what do you think you and Val are capable of doing? You're such a great established pairing.
Yeah, we are. Look, we've been mates for 30 something years. And, you know, we know each other so well. We're both competitive. We're both stubborn. We both work hard. And so there's, you know, what will be, but, you know, I know Val's prepared well as I have. So there's no excuses down there for, you know, if we don't do well. Yeah, we've prepared well. And, but, you know, tomorrow's another day.